An appeal from Palestine to the world. Palestinian ambassador to the Philippines, Saleh Mohammed, urging world leaders to reconsider their stand on the war. He says Israel's response to the brutal attacks of Hamas has gone beyond self-defense. He adds, seeing how the world is supporting Israel by providing it with more arms to attack Gaza is painful and unfortunate.
They sympathized and gave the message of solidarity with the state of Israel, that they have the right to defend themselves and to exist. It's okay. I mean, that was no problem, you know. But the question is this, when Israel wrongly read this message and they went, perpetrating genocides, crimes against the humanity, this same world leader should have come again another statement, okay, we have given you the right, we give you solidarity, but what they are doing is absolutely wrong. The Gaza Strip is totally closed, and then what? I mean, what next? Are they going to suffocate all Gaza people living in Gaza until death? You know, what is the world is doing? What is the world work in this? What's the world, you know, reaction on this?
Mohammed also wants to draw the world's attention to the core problem, which he says is the continued occupation by Israel of Palestinian territories.
Hamas is not Palestine. Hamas is an organization. Hamas is an organization trying to fight for the liberation of Palestine in the full absence. What made Hamas Hamas is the absence of a real political hope for the Palestinian people. No, you cannot just oppress people, keep them under your feet, and expect that they will keep their mouth shut and they will not move. I'm not trying to justify, but this is what exactly going on. This is what exactly happening. So Hamas is not the only people. It's faction, a small portion of the Palestinian people.
Secretary Blinken is now in Jordan as he continues his diplomatic push to prevent a wider war in the Middle East. America's top diplomat is set to hold meetings with King Abdullah and Palestinian Authority President Mahmoud Abbas. Blinken also plans to visit key American allies Qatar and Saudi Arabia, plus Egypt and the United Arab Emirates, some of which have influence on Hamas. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken vows America's unwavering support for Israel as he visits the war-torn nation. And as this report tells us, Blinken also talked to Israel about the humanitarian needs of the people in the besieged Gaza Strip.
Israelis have begun to bury the dead, including this man who was killed during the fighting at the Be'eri kibbutz in southern Israel. Secretary of State Antony Blinken spent the day in Israel meeting with top officials, including Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, and Israelis grieving the loss of their loved ones. Blinken said he arrived in the country not just as a U.S. diplomat, but also as a Jew, father, and husband. In this moment where he said the suffering is hard to fathom.
The message that I bring to Israel is this. You may be strong enough on your own to defend yourself, but as long as America exists, you will never ever have to. We will always be there by your side.
Blinken said he plans to meet with leaders in the region to try to prevent spreading of violence that has claimed at least 2,800 lives on both sides, and to try to win the release of some 150 hostages Hamas is still holding. As Israel continued to pound Gaza City with airstrikes, Blinken said he and Israeli leaders discussed ways to address the humanitarian needs of Gaza residents. Blinken said he also planned to bring up the possibilities for safe passage of civilians out of Gaza during meetings with regional leaders in the coming days. Israel is gathering massive forces, tanks, and other heavy armor around the occupied Palestinian territory as it continues its retaliatory campaign against what Prime Minister Netanyahu called the sheer evil of terror attacks by Hamas. Cindy Sain, VOA News.
The deepening humanitarian crisis in Gaza. thousands of civilians at risk of starvation as Israel withholds essential supplies in response to the brutal attacks of Hamas militants. Israel has declared there will be no exceptions to its complete siege of Gaza until hostages are freed. Airstrikes have reduced entire communities in Gaza to rubble, killing over 1,400 Palestinians, including at least 500 children. The United Nations described the situation in the Gaza Strip as dire, with critical supplies running dangerously low.
We're very worried about how this will evolve over time, particularly if the humanitarian situation is not addressed. The people that are seeking shelter and striving to survive in this environment are going to get only in worse and worse situations as time goes on. And I think our concern is that unless we're able to access those communities, the people that are in need, the civilian population, there's going to be an extreme situation for them, both in terms of having the food to survive, the water to survive, and the other services, even shelter over their heads.
The international community of the Red Cross also warning fuel for hospital generators in Gaza would run out in a matter of hours. The entry of aid and medicine from the group also blocked.
Aid needs to come with a safe and secure humanitarian space. We have supply. We need more supply, but if we can't move to reach people, if we cannot move to reach hospital, if we cannot move to reach essential infrastructure, we can all have all the supply of the world. It won't make a difference. So there is supply. We need more supply because we believe the violence won't stop tomorrow. And on top, and most importantly, we need security.
Over in Israel, the parliament approves Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's emergency unity government. The wartime government underlines the suspension of normal political rules during one of the most serious crises in Israel's history. The cabinet includes a number of centrist opposition lawmakers to display Israel's determination to win the war against Hamas. The Israeli death toll in the war has risen to over 1,300. More than 100 Israelis were also taken hostage by Hamas. In the U.S., New York officials are on high alert ahead of planned large-scale Israel-Palestine protests for Friday. State Governor Kathy Hochul assured residents there is no reason to be afraid, adding authorities are prepared for the demonstrations. New York City Mayor Eric Adams said the police department will be sending additional units to high-profile synagogues and mosques to prevent attacks on any houses of worship.
I want every New Yorker, especially Jewish New Yorkers and other groups, to know there are currently no credible or specific threats against our city. But with large-scale protests planned for tomorrow, we must remain vigilant.
There is currently no intelligence showing any active threats in New York. That is the entire state of New York. But in a moment fraught like this, we will continue to exercise elevated vigilance and impose measures to deter any potential violence. Let's talk about what we're planning to do in response to tomorrow's elevated threat. We fully activated our Division of Homeland Security and Emergency Services, Office of Counterterrorism. State police have been fully activated. We have a strong presence throughout the state, as well as here in the city.